welcome to C3 Arts Radio. This is your loyal host, Philip Harvey, coming live and direct to you from City College, New York, of course, the college on the Hill. And we are the broadcast arm of the City College Center for the Arts. And I'm here in the studio with my partner in crime here, Mr. Winston Brewington. How are you today, Winston?
I'm doing great, actually. Doing great, man. I'm glad that you made it here. I know you're a little under the weather, but you're soldiering through, man.
Yeah, what can you do, man? What can you do?
Hey,
you
know? Exactly.
Yes. As you were saying earlier, change of weather, all that kind of stuff, sometimes it gets you, you know?
Yeah, it got me last week, so I know how you're feeling, man.
Yeah. But, you know, it's so important for us. We have another great show lined up here today on C3 Arts Radio, and you know we come to you every Tuesday right here at WHCR 90.3 FM. And, we're also online. You can always check us out online as well. So please go to at C3 Arts Radio. That's our handle on Instagram. And, you know, really trying to build up our Instagram page. It's looking better and better.
But you can also, I think it looks great, man.
Yeah, we're getting there, you know. We're getting there. But you can also follow us on Twitter. That's at C3 Arts Radio, Facebook C3 Arts Radio. And also, of course, you can check out our website, c3artsradio.com. And that's where we give you the information, you know, and share some things with you. And that's something we're going to be doing today. We got a great day lined up for you. We're going to be doing another segment of what we like to call here Sliced Fruit. And that is where we give you our choices, our selections of all the fantastic, wonderful things going on in the world of arts and culture. That's what we do here at C3 Arts Radio. But as the broadcast arm of the City College Center for the Arts, it's very important that we make sure that you know what is happening right here on the campus of City College, right here at City College Center for the Arts, on the stages of Aaron Davis Hall and in the other areas of cultural enlightenment that we have around campus. So let's get to it, okay? So really, for the last couple of weeks, we have this block of events that are happening at Aaron Davis Hall. So we're gonna go through one more time. I wanna make sure that hopefully most of you got your tickets already, but if you haven't, there's still time. Let's go through and see what we're talking about here, okay? First of all, tomorrow evening, we have the Manhattan School of Music Comes to Harlem series, which is going to be featuring the Manhattan School of Music Afro-Cuban Jazz Orchestra. That's right, Afro-Cuban Jazz Orchestra. Also, if you are familiar with what's happening at the Manhattan School of Music, of course you know that it is one of the great generators of musical talent in this country that the United States puts out. There are a number of other schools as well, but you have to put the Manhattan School of Music right up there with them. Now, one of the reasons why we have to do this, why we have to do it, it's imperative, is because of Mr. Bobby Santabria, who is the music director and conductor of the Latin Jazz Orchestra. So, this is going to be iteration. It's going to be the Afro-Cuban Jazz Orchestra performing at Aaron Davis Hall at 7:30 p.m. That is tomorrow. So you still have time to get tickets. Go to citycollegecenterfortheArts.org. Now, on Thursday, the following day, we have the Langston Hughes Festival is going to be going on. And this year, we are honoring, of course, the great Zadie Smith, one of the leading writers that we have producing work at this point in time. The young shift, I should say. Well, there's always younger and younger, right? There's always generations. That's what makes it so great. There's always new generations. But that does nothing to dilute the position that Zadie Smith has. She is a fantastic writer, of course, writer of books like White Teeth and Swing Time, which was her most recent work. Well, she will be honored at the Langston Hughes Festival. That's going to take place Thursday. There are two times for this now, okay? So at 12:30 p.m., there's going to be a symposium on the work of Zadie Smith. And then at 6:30, we'll have the award ceremony where we'll actually honor Zadie Smith. Now, there'll be musical accompaniment, food, drinks. Come out and enjoy. That's the Langston Hughes Festival. It's the 2017 version, right? This is an annual festival here at City College. It's going to be taking place Thursday, Aaron Davis Hall, November 16th. Now, also, we keep going, right? It's a whole block of these things, right? So on Saturday, November 18th, 7 p.m., we have the Bobby Lewis Ensemble 20th Anniversary Concert. It's going to be taking place at Aaron Davis Hall. Of course, let me tell you, the Bobby Lewis Ensemble has a huge following. Fantastic at what they do. Please, you can go to citycollegecenterforthearts.org to figure out how to get some tickets here. Or you can go to nlbcnyc.org, okay? The nlbcnyc.org. That's the website of the Bobby Lewis Ensemble. And last but not least, you got to get to this soon, right? Void of Death, the solo exhibition by Julio Mejia, is still going to be up until the 27th, so time is running out. So please make sure that you stop by the Aaron Davis Hall Gallery to check it out. Okay, so the gallery is open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. So make sure you get by. And that's what we're talking about, ladies and gentlemen. City College Center for the Arts. It's a nice lineup, I think.
Yeah, there's a lot of great stuff going on.
Yeah.
Gotta get your tickets if you don't have them.
That's right. You told us. I like that. So, C3 Arts Radio, that's what we do. We're the broadcast arm of City College Center for the Arts, but we do a whole lot more. And we shall return with a little action on what's going on. We'll get into our today's guests and such, okay? All right. Slice Food coming up. C3 Arts Radio. We'll be right back. And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. We are always, always back right here, C3Arts Radio. And, you know, we have this segment. It's a renamed segment. I named it Sliced Fruit. See, now, and the origins of the name Sliced Fruit come from my brother, Brooke Stevenson. Well-known name, I think, around here in New York, of course, in his original city of Detroit as well. And this is what he called it back in the day, where he would give his thoughts, his ideas to, he said that he was offering sliced fruit. And so, like that name, so in honor of Brooke Stevenson, we've taken it on here at C3Arts Radio to name our segment where we give you our selections on what we think you should check out, what you should be seeing. Now, of course, this is against a huge backdrop of cultural events that we try to make sure that you are aware of. Please, and in doing that, we try to invite you to our social media function so you can go there and get some of that information. Now, these are just some of the ideas that we call from what we offer online, just to give you an introduction, right? It's all about information. We got to share the information with you. So Winston and I, we're just going to go back and forth, okay? We're going to go right back and forth on you and give you our choices. So I guess I'll get started, Winston. What you think, yeah?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, all right. So I'm going to give you somewhat of a national idea of what's happening here. So in Atlanta, at the High Museum of Art. So for all our people listening in Atlanta, I know there are a few of you. I want to say, give you a shout out before I say this. But here's a little information for you. If you don't know, the High Museum, okay, has an exhibition. It's called Making Africa, a Continent of Contemporary Design. Now, this is the U.S. debut of this exhibition. It is, as we will call, a global production, we might say, and it's making its U.S. debut. Well, it presents the latest in African design, has more than 120 artists working across photography, film, sculpture, fashion, furniture, digital comics, foray into all areas of creative production to kind of give you a sense of what work is coming out of Africa, to give you a kind of sense, at least from the artist's perspective, of what we're looking at when we're thinking of the emergence of Africa, as we like to say. Kind of offers a vision of Africa in the 21st century and kind of shows how the promise that is there. The exhibition is going to go from the High Museum. It's there until January 7th, okay? So you got a little bit of time, but I want to put this on your schedule, okay? Put it on your calendar. Because after leaving Atlanta, it's going to go to the Albuquerque Museum in New Mexico and the Blanton Museum of Art in Austin, Texas. So our friends in that region of the country, get ready. It's coming at the beginning of the new year, okay? All right. What you thinking about there?
All right. So as I was looking through some of the upcoming events going on in New York, I found something really interesting at the Studio Museum in Harlem, which is
very close.
Really cool. Yeah, very close to us. Cool museum. Really like what they do over there. And I saw that they have this exhibit called Fictions. And so Fictions is going to feature 19 young emerging African-American artists that are given their shot at the limelight in this show, the fifth in a series of surveys that feature titles such as Freestyle, Frequency, Flow, Four, and they all start with the letter F. So this exhibit's gonna be open until January 6th. So you have a little bit of time, but you know, if you have time, you know, on a weekend, this is definitely something cool to do. It's a really cool museum. It's a good size. You can see all the exhibits. You can take your time. So I really encourage people to go out and see that.
Yeah, there's something about that on a nice Saturday or Sunday.
Absolutely.
And go to the Studio Museum. Great choice. Next up, we have an exhibition that honors Malik Sidibe. Now, Malik Sidibe, of course, is the photographer. We see this kind of the case of identity, right? And we're talking about people who are documenting lives and making us understand other parts of the world. Well, Malik Sidibe was way ahead of his time, right? And the Foundation Cartier in Paris is paying tribute to Malik Sidibe, right? The recently departed, unfortunately, Malik Sidibe. This is a major retrospective, and it's a selection of black and white photographs dating from the 1960s when Sidibe first started to get into the public consciousness by kind of documenting the lives of the newly independent African youth. Or from different countries, right? Okay. The post-independence transformation, right? Particularly of Mali. But Malik Sidibe, he was a guy who got around, and this gives a lot of it. This one is actually called Mali Twist, and it's a vast collection of vintage photographs and portraits from his archives. And this particular show, you got a little bit of time. If you have a trip planned to Paris, for all our people over in the City of Lights who might be listening to us right now, you're on call. You have to go see this. You have to honor Malik Sidibe. There will also be an exhibition catalog that's going to accompany the exhibition for all of us who may not have the chance to get there. So it's Malik Sidibe, Mali Twist. It's at the Foundation Cartier in Paris. It's going to be there until February 28th, 2018. Check it out.
Dang, I gotta book my tickets to Paris.
yeah, make it an adventure. Yeah,
man. So I'm gonna go with another art exhibit. This at the Museum of Contemporary Art. This is downtown New York, 235 Bowery. And the name of the exhibit's called Trigger: Gender as a Tool and a Weapon. And with all the different things going on in culture, with physical and mental abuse of women in particular, but men as well, this exhibit kind of puts a spotlight on those things that are happening. It also goes a little bit into the political realm, talking about the way the world is currently under the administration under 45.
I like it. 45. Yeah.
45, yeah. You know,
that's almost too imposing a name.
I know, right?
45. That makes it sound more serious than it is. Well, he's serious. Okay.
Yeah, you know.
Another story, another day, right?
Exactly. Another story, another day. But it seemed like a really interesting exhibit. I'm going to go check it out myself. It seems like something that everyone should go see. It will be open for another 3 months, I believe. So you have a little bit of time. But definitely go check that out. It's downtown Bowery. It's the new Museum of Contemporary Art, and it's called Trigger.
The new museum. They have very, very interesting programming. I'm glad that they are very timely with this exhibition, we could say.
Absolutely.
And speaking of something which is timely, in a sense, in terms of, unless the creator kind of shift of what has been happening in recent years, our last thing is going to be a good segue for us because of who we have coming to hang out with us here, or at least figuratively, via phone. But there is a documentary. It's done in the auspices of HBO, and it's called Baltimore Rising. Yeah. And what it does is it follows the activists, police officers, community leaders, and gang affiliates who really struggled to keep Baltimore together after kind of police and just the fissures between law enforcement and the communities of Baltimore really ruptured and really went open. There was a lot to it. Baltimore handled it very differently than we see some of the other cities who had to deal with similar incidents. And luckily, Sonia Son, of course, Sonia Son, who was star of The Wire, among a number of other projects, which I've always liked. I've followed the career of Sonia Son.
Yeah, she's really talented. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. And she's very serious, in a way. Yeah, very serious about her. And so this is her directorial debut. And, or at least I believe it's her directorial debut. And the film's going to be available on HBO. You're going to be able to get it on demand on Tuesday, November 21st. Okay. It's going to be available on demand on Monday, the 20th. But it's going to... am I looking at this right? Okay. So it's going to air Monday, 20th. And it will be available the next day on the 21st. So Tuesday, 21st, you'll be able to get it on demand. And they'll air it on Monday, November 20th at 8 p.m. And of course, the documentary is called Baltimore Rising. And it's very important. I think you're going to be hearing a whole lot about it in the coming weeks.
Yeah, man, I mean, it's phenomenal, phenomenal project. Mm-hmm. Got a chance to watch it last night. And everyone did a great job. I definitely encourage people to go see that.
Really good. Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. It was, I imagine that, was there a sense of relief or attention in watching the film?
I don't want to give too much away, but I guess I definitely walked away from the theater with many more questions than I had.
Wow.
But in a good way.
Uh-huh.
Because it's a cycle. It's like always going on. Like, these incidents, unfortunately, will probably continue to happen. But it's really about people coming together, trying to figure out ways to, you know, stop these things from happening, or try to prevent these things from happening, and really make a change, you know, through legislation, through community outreach. And, you know, I mean, it was just interesting to see the different stories of these people that they followed in this film, because everyone has a different perspective and everyone's affected differently.
Yeah. Yeah. So it follows a number of different people from different parts of the community, right?
Exactly.
When I say community, I mean kind of writ large, the city of Baltimore, right? And
exactly.
It seems fascinating because it goes from how do you respond to this into how do you turn that into a call for action, which is very interesting as well.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Definitely go see it. It's really, really good. Really enjoyed it.
And it's coming to you, ladies and gentlemen. Baltimore Rising. We still got a lot more to deal with.
Absolutely.
In these issues on how we're going to do that. Yep.
Absolutely.
All right. So C3 Arts Radio. See, I tell you. See, we give you the information. Sliced fruit. And I think we got one more, don't we?
Yes. So one more piece of information for you.
This is important.
Oh, yeah. For fans of the great Kamasi Washington, he's going to be performing at Terminal 5 in New York City. So that's in Midtown. That's going to be Wednesday, November 22nd. So that'll be the Wednesday before Thanksgiving.
That's right.
So it'll be, you won't have to work the next day for most people. So it'll be a great time. Go watch a great show. The guy is phenomenal. Special guest appearance by Robert Randolph, which is also phenomenal. So it's going to be a great show. I'm going to try to get my tickets as soon as possible, but Terminal 5 is a great venue. It's got great sound. It's really big. I mean, there's upstairs, there's downstairs. It's, you know, but I'm really looking forward to that show. That should be amazing.
Okay, well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Sliced fruit for November the 14th. C3 Arts Radio. We'll be right back.
that pledge. All that I owe, I'd give it all to you. If this world were only mine, if this world were only mine, baby. Loving combination, you give me inspiration. Good vibration, now we are together. If this world, if this world, if this world were only mine, boy, oh, well, at your feet would I place all that I hold, I'd give it unto you. A good, good vibration. Give me inspiration, both day and night. Oh, boy, 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 yeah. Really, I let you leave, you give me good vibe. You give me good vibe. You're giving me a good vibe all the time. About day and night, you give me good vibe. I pray thee. Loving combination, a good, good vibration. You give me inspiration about day and night. Oh, hey, if this world were only mine, at your feet would I place, oh yeah, all did I own, yeah, all did I own, yeah, loving combination, give me inspiration, good vibration, of day and night, if this world were your feet would I place all that I hold. This world were only mine. This world were only mine, yeah. If this world were only mine.
In this life, yes, yes, of happiness and sadness, all right. When you've lost out on love, I know, and it all ends up in madness, baby. And you say, love, please go away, don't torture me. Something's real. Someone you feel comes in. Now I'm falling in love again. I'm falling in love again. I'm falling in love all over. I'm falling in love again. She loved me. I'm falling.
And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. Always, always back right here at C3 Arts Radio. The broadcast arm of the City College Center for the Arts, coming to you live and direct from City College, New York. And we're here, ladies and gentlemen. That was a big music block right there. We decided to give you a little music. You know, as we always say here at C3 Arts Radio, sometimes you just gotta let the music play. Yeah, so we had a little block of music for your enjoyment there. So please remember, if you want more information, if you want more things dealing with sliced fruit, if you want some more fruit, please go and check us out online. That's at C3 Arts Radio. It's on Twitter, at C3 Arts Radio, on Instagram, C3 Arts Radio, Facebook, and then C3ArtsRadio.com, of course, and our beautiful, gorgeous website.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Yes, yes, absolutely, absolutely. So now, so we told you about this great lineup that we have coming up here at City College Center for the Arts that we're doing, of course, with at Aaron Davis Hall. Now, what we want to do is we want to make sure you get here. So we want to give you out some tickets to you. So this is how we're going to do it. Remember last month when we did the same thing, you see, and a few times in the past. Well, it's kind of a regular thing now. We really want to get people out to check out what's happening here at City College, New York, right? So this is the way we can work things out, right? A little bit of trivia. A lot of information. We're all about information here. That's the cusp of what we do here. So we've instituted, of course, this trivia game, right? Where you can win tickets to come see show Aaron Davis Hall. Sounds like a fair deal. We just traded a little bit on your knowledge, okay? So the way it works is that we will ask the question. And then if you will tweet your answer to us, right? Just get on, choose a tweet, at C3 Arts Radio, right? And let us know what the answer is. You'll win two free tickets. Tickets will be held for you at the box office for the Manhattan School of Music Come to Harlem series featuring the Manhattan School of Music Afro-Cuban Jazz Orchestra, being conducted, of course, by the great Bobby Sanabria. And that's going to be tomorrow. So if you were thinking about going and you thought you couldn't get the tickets, you thought it was too late, first of all, it's not. Second of all, we'll take care of that for you. All you have to do is answer a very, very easy question. Well, maybe. It might be easy. It might be easy. Okay. All right. So here's the question. So there once was a young man. His name was Miles Dewey Davis.
I think I heard him.
You heard him?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. He's been around. He pops up here and there, you know. Then there's this thing where he had like 5 decades of kind of innovating and changing music and this whole thing, but you know, I digress. Well, Miles Dewey Davis, at the very height of his career, let's say the early to mid 50s or late 50s, okay? We know that there were two great bands that Miles Davis headed, or generally we think of this way, before he went electric, let's say, okay? Before Electric Miles, there were two fantastic bands that he had, and it just showed his ability to not only discover talent, but to nurture it and bring it forth. You think about all the whole generations of jazz musicians that came up through some affiliation of Miles Davis, then you know what I'm talking about. But he had one partner in particular, someone who was his right man through his great string of hits in the 1950s, which really kind of solidified the Miles Davis brand. Now, this man was generally a pianist by trade, but of course he was a composer. He had an ear for every instrument. And it is with Miles that these two uber musicians put their heads together and came up with what some people like to call classic Miles Davis music. Now, this guy, this partner we're talking about, he couldn't have been any more different than Miles Davis. A very, very different personality. They say opposites attract, opposites do good work together, something like that, right? Well, this man couldn't have been any more different than Miles, but together they were able to create a great sound. So we're talking about Kind of Blue. All right. We're talking about Sketches of Spain. Right? We're talking about this era. What I want you to do is I want you to send us a tweet at C3 Arts Radio. Please tell us the name of this pianist, this composer, this jazz giant in his own right who helped compose the great string of hits in the 1950s of Miles Davis, okay? So if you'll tweet us that name, you can get 2 tickets to the Manhattan School of Music Come to Harlem series concert featuring the Manhattan School of Music Afro-Cuban Jazz Orchestra with Bobby Sanabria as the music director and conductor. So get on there, shoot us a line, we'll get you the tickets, and we'll come back to the answer at the end of the show before we get out of here. So this is C3 Arts Radio. See, we're just full of tricks here, full of gifts, full of gifts. We'll see you in a moment. Yeah.
friends. Well, oh yeah, all did I own. Yeah, all did I own. Yeah, laughing combination, give me inspiration.
Back, ladies and gentlemen, C3Arts Radio. And we're about to get out of here, actually. Hope you enjoyed another episode. We gave you sliced fruit. Please know that you can always go and get more information. There's more where that came from. Please check us out online at C3Arts Radio. That's Twitter and Instagram, C3Arts Radio, Facebook, C3ArtsRadio.com. And for all the people who have tweeted to us the answer to our question, who was the co-composer who was at least partially responsible for the great run that Miles Davis had during the 1950s. Now, if you got on Twitter and you sent us a tweet at C3 Arts Radio, and your tweet, of course, said the great Gil Evans, then you were correct. And you are going to get two tickets to see the Manhattan School of Music Afro-Cuban Jazz Orchestra at Aaron Davis Hall tomorrow night, right? So get ready. It's a date, you know, make it a date. Make it a whole evening. It's fantastic. Great music, great time. Manhattan School of Music, Come to Harlem series featuring the Manhattan School of Music Afro-Cuban Jazz Orchestra with Bobby Santabria as the music director and conductor. So make sure you check it out. So we're about to get out of here. Let's see. I'm going to give my man Winston here the last word of the evening. What you think to take us out of here, Winston?
Well, I just want everyone to, you know, take in all this art and all the good things that we have. You know, Thanksgiving's coming up next week, so it's a good time to count your blessings and to spend time with your friends and family. And, just want to preach positivity. Hope everyone out there is doing well. Stay positive. Keep working towards your goals and keep it moving.
All right. I like that. I like that. And stay warm and dry out here. It's cold out here, all right?
Don't get
sick like me, okay? All right. C3 Arts Radio, ladies and gentlemen. You know that we will be back. We'll see you next week.